Top of the hour, 11 p.m., just after here on the East Coast. It has been 2 weeks since George Floyd died in police custody. The video of a Minneapolis police officer with his knee on Floyd's neck shocked the nation, leading to mass protests all across this country, even around the world. A new CNN poll shows 84% of Americans say the peaceful protests of police violence against African Americans are justified. That's leading to growing calls for action against police. But instead of addressing the anger and unrest in this country, this is what the president said about the police today.
We want to make sure we don't have any bad actors in there. And sometimes you'll see some horrible things like we witnessed recently, but 99.9, but let's go with 99% of them are great, great people, and they've done jobs that are record-setting.
Meanwhile, the Attorney General is contradicting the president's story about why he was in an underground bunker during protests outside the White House.
I went down during the day, and I was there for a tiny, little short period of time, and it was much more for an inspection. There was no problem during the day.
Things were so bad that the Secret Service recommended the president go down to the bunker. We can't have that in our country.
We'll see how the president responds to that. Let's discuss now. John Harwood and national political reporter for the New York Times and Sam Herndon both join me. Good evening. Just a quick note, NASCAR, interesting conversation, don't you think, gentlemen? The president's base and he's saying, hey, move on down the road if you don't want to deal with the new way that we're going to conduct ourselves in NASCAR. We're going to be watching that one. John, you just heard the Attorney General clearly contradicting the president on why he was so obsessed with lying about going to the bunker. What gives?
Well, what gives is, you know, you just talked about NASCAR and the president's base. The president has constructed a political base that is disproportionately composed of blue-collar white men. And he projects for them an image of toughness. He's done it since his campaign, talking about wanting to punch protesters, getting tough with immigrants and firing the SOB NFL players and roughing up criminal suspects. It's a very macho kind of projection. And so if the idea got out, and it did get out the previous Friday, that the president had gone down into the bunker for protection from these protesters in the wake of the Floyd killing, that was a laser shot right at his image of toughness. So they staged this a walk over to the church and cleared the street to do that. He pumped his fist while he was walking, the tough guy gesture with a chairman of the Joint Chiefs behind him. And then when he got the chance of the interview, he said, oh, no, I wasn't going down to the bunker. I was just going down to inspect it. Unfortunately for him, the Attorney General felt the need to protect his reputation because he's gotten fingered for giving the order for the troops to move. And he was trying to paint a picture that things were so dire that we needed to do that. And so he exposed that the president had not been telling the truth. And of course, the irony is that it's made all of them look bad, made the president's position weaker rather than stronger. And our poll today showed him down 14 points against
Trump. Let's talk about these polls. A new CNN poll out today shows that 65% of Americans think the president's response to protests his response has been harmful. We're talking about Democrats and Republicans here. First, John, and then instead I'm gonna talk about a poll with you, but how nervous is the White House tonight, you think about that, John?
Extremely. Look, he's losing badly to Joe Biden right now. He gets very negative assessments for how he handled coronavirus, which is a disaster both in public health terms and economic terms. Forget the good jobs report last Friday. It was good in a limited way, but the economy is still a mess, even though the stock market's going up. And now he's getting panned for his handling of these protests, like by 2-1 margin. So his political position is weak, and it's, as you indicated, it's Democrats unanimously, a majority of independents, and a small number, but a growing number of Republicans who have just had enough of this.
As I mentioned, 84% of people think that these peaceful protests are justified. I imagine those people don't approve of using pepper spray and rubber bullets against protesters. So why is the White House still defending the Lafayette Park fiasco?
It's because they have a president who will not allow them to give an inch. I mean, this is a president, as John said, who believes that those indictments go straight to his personality, straight to the image that he is trying to project. And so there is an unwillingness to square that with even what is the political possibilities that were afforded to him by these two crises. I mean, I think of the quote from Game of Thrones, that chaos can be a ladder. He had two opportunities to really show himself as a different unifying figure, someone who leads, someone who could rise to the occasion in a way that would overshadow maybe some of the things that had happened in 3 years prior. But he has fallen on that ladder. He has not shown the willingness to be able to rise to that occasion. And I think voters are picking up on that. I was in Georgia a couple days ago in the most conservative county in the state. And it was remarkable to me just how many people were willing to universally agree that the actions of the police officer were wrong and that the protesters were justified. If they're operating from that place, then that gives the that gives the president less wiggle room to be able to make this solely about looting or rioting in limited aspects. There are larger civil rights questions here at play, and he has not dealt with those.
Wow, good conversation. Instead, John, thank you so much. Appreciate it.